Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as we know, we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Components of food. In that already we have discussed the one nutrients. Okay, in that lesson what we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss the different types of the nutrients, which are the sources of that nutrients and which diseases are causes, which deficiency diseases are causes due to the lack of that particular nutrients. In that we have already discussed the one nutrient yesterday, that is nothing but what? Carbohydrates. Okay, so yesterday we have discussed what is meant by carbohydrate, why we need it and which are the sources of carbohydrate. And the carbohydrate is also called as what? Energy giving food. Okay, so from the different food items we are getting the carbohydrate, but there is a one test. With the help of that test we can come to know whether the substance or whether the food items which is we are eating, in that carbohydrate is present or not. Or to get to know whether that particular food sub contain carbohydrate or no, we can take one test, and with the help of that we can come to know that this substance is containing the carbohydrate. Okay, so let's start with that. So first we will take the test of the carbohydrate. To test the presence of starch in a given sample. Starch means what? Nothing but one type of carbohydrate that yesterday we have discussed. Okay, so we can find out whether the given substance containing starch or no with the help of one activity. For that we required the raw potato, also we required the iodine solution. Okay, so let's start with this activity. We have to take one potato and we have to cut it. Okay, so on the cut surface of the potato we have to add this one or two drop of the iodine solution. Okay, so see, this is the cut portion. Now you can see it properly, it is a white in color. Okay, it is a white in color. So let's start the activity. So which things are required for that? We require the raw potato, iodine solution and one dropper. We require to do this activity. So let's start for the this activity. So here I have taken the one raw potato and I have cut it. So take the surface of the potato upside, on that put the some drops of the iodine solution. Okay, see, I am putting the few drops of the iodine on it. See, I am putting 3 drops of iodine solution I have put on the surface of on the cut surface of the potato. Okay, so see, we'll wait for the some time, and after that what we can see? Now you can see that the color of the potato is what? Blue black color. Okay, why it get turns into the blue black color? Because this potato contains the starch, and when the starch comes in a contact of iodine, then it get convert into the color, and in which color it forms? It gets the blue black color. So this potato gets converts into the blue black color. That's why we can say that what? Potato contain starch. Okay, so this is the presence of the starch, or this is the confirmatory test for the starch, which tell us what? The potato contain the starch. And why we can say like that? Why we, how we can conclude that? Because when the starch comes into the iodine solution, then the starch get converts into the blue black color. So when we add the iodine drops on this solution, on this raw potato, the cut surface of the raw potato get converted into the blue black color. This explain us, this proves us that potato contain starch, and the starch is what? Nothing but the one type of carbohydrate. Okay, so this is all about carbohydrate. So today we'll move for the next nutrient. Today we'll discuss about the next nutrient, that is nothing but what? Proteins. So as we know, there are the 5 main nutrients that comes in our diet, that are carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, so already we have completed the first one, that is carbohydrate, and today we'll see the next nutrient, that is nothing but what? Proteins. Okay, so let's start. So this protein is necessary to make our body, to build our body, and it gives us energy also. and that's why this protein is called as what? Body building food. Okay, the protein is helps to build our body, that's why the protein is called as body building food. Okay, so why this protein is necessary, why we have to take this protein in our diet? Because the protein is necessary for the proper growth and repairs of the body. Okay, so why the protein is necessary? Protein is necessary for proper growth and repairs of the body. Now repairs of the body means what happens? Sometimes cuts is happens on our body, sometimes body get damaged. Okay, so all these get repair, all these cuts, all these wounds get healed. Why? With the help of this protein, our skin, with the help of that cuts, our we can get, after some time we'll get our normal skin. Okay, we can understand also, so that we were having a cut on our body, like that we can say. So how these all these cuts and wound gets healed? With the help of these proteins. Okay, so the protein is necessary for the growth and repairs of the body. Okay, next one is there. So see here, why is necessary protein for the growth and the repairs of the body? That is the reason the growing children like you, yes, the growing children like you, this requires the more amount of protein rich food. Also the pregnant woman also requires a more amount of the food, and the person, those who are getting cover from the illness. Okay, because during the illness we are having the weakness, so to get come out from that, our body requires the more amount of the protein which builds our body, and that is the reason growing children, who are pregnant woman, and a person, those who are recovering from the illness, all these persons requires the more amount of the protein. Why? Because they need the more amount of the protein for their proper growth and to repairs the body. Okay, so now the next point we'll discuss, that which are the sources of protein. Okay, so let's see. So basically sources, as we know, the food we are getting from the plants or the animals. Okay, so like that the proteins also we are getting. There are the sources of protein which comes under the plants also and the animals also. So there are the certain plant sources which gives us protein, and there are the some animal sources are also there which are also gives us protein. So let's discuss. So basically the sources of the proteins, or the we are getting the proteins from plants and the animals. So in the plant product, the foodstuffs which are rich in the proteins are beans. Now beans means what? Kidney beans are there, soya beans are there, okay, moth beans are there, all these are rich in the proteins. Okay, now the next one we can say that nuts. Nuts like cashew nut is there, almond is there, hazelnut is there, walnut is there, groundnut, all these are the different nuts which are providing us proteins. Okay, next one, different types of the pulses. Now pulses we can say that moong dal is there, different types of the grams are there, tur dal is also there. Okay, all these are the pulses, all these are different types of the pulses which are also rich in the proteins. Okay, now the next one we see that cereals. Yes, so it is a very common cereals means what? Rice, then jowar, bajra, ragi, maize, corn, all these are the plants product, or all these are the crops which comes under cereals, and all these are also providing us the some amount of the proteins. Okay, so the next one we will discuss about the animal sources which are rich in a protein. Which are the animal sources which are rich in a protein? We can say that meat, okay, that we are getting from the goat. Okay, so in this way also we can say the fish, eggs, milk and milk products. Now milk and milk products like we can say the curd, cheese, paneer. Okay, all these are what? Milk products which are rich in what? Proteins. Okay, so all these are the sources of the protein. From all these foodstuffs we are getting the protein. Okay, so all these are the things that today we have discussed about the proteins. Let's revise again what we can say for the proteins. Protein is helps to build our body, that's why the protein is called as body building food. It is necessary for the growth and the repairs of the body, that's why it is necessary in the, it requires in more amount during the growing stage of the children, pregnant, in the pregnant woman and the person, those who are recovering from the illness. Next one, there are the different sources of the protein. Some are comes in a a plant sources, amal comes in a animal sources. Okay, so this is all about protein. Also today we have discussed about the taste of the carbohydrate. In the carbohydrate we can find out whether the carbohydrate, that is the one type of the carbohydrate, starch. So we can find out whether the food substance is containing starch or no with the help of the iodine solution. Okay, so this is all about today. So today I will end my class. For tomorrow we will again meet and we will discuss the next point of the lesson. For today, thank you.